So today we are going to build a phone assistant using a large language model and the Twilio API. And I've started from an empty HTTP server. This is written in TypeScript and uses the HONO library, which is great. And this server is tunneled to the internet with Anti-Rock. So I bought this phone number here. And essentially every time someone calls it, it will send a request to this HTTP server. So let's see that happens. Let's run the HTTP server and call the number.
You're sorry, an application error.
Okay, so obviously we got an error, but we see that by calling the number, we got a post HTTP request to this API. And now we need to implement this API. So this will be post and slash incoming call. This request will be called when someone calls our phone number. And right here, we will need to return an XML response that Twilio can understand. So in order to format this response, let's start by importing the Twilio library. And now we can start formatting the response. So this looks like this. And we can essentially provide a command to Twilio. So this could look like this. So right after this, you know, Twilio will say, hello, how are you in the phone? And this is an XML response. So we need to format that. And let's return the body. Cool. So now we can save the file and start calling again.
Hello, how are you?
Cool. Now we want to listen to the user. So for that, we'll use the gather command and we'll need to pass a couple of parameters here. First of all, we need to tell Twilio that we want to gather speech and we can specify the timeouts for the speech. So essentially by passing auto at Twilio will stop speech recognition when there is a pause in speech. And to specify the speech to text model, we are going to use the speech model parameter. And essentially we can pass a parameter to make sure to use kind of a premium speech model to improve the accuracy of the transcription. And once the transcription is actually done, then Twilio will call this API endpoint slash respond, which we need to implement. Twilio will pass the result of the speech recognition model in this HTTP request in the foreign data. So let's start by collecting it. And I think this is an async function, so we'll need to make this async. And it will pass it in a variable called speech result. So we can just convert this to a string and store it in a variable. And just for the testing, so here we'll need to essentially call the OpenAI API, the large language model, and start a conversation. But just for now, let's just repeat what the user said. So I'm going to copy this response. And right here, instead of replying back with, hello, how are you? Let's just reply back with exactly what the user said. And here we have a small error because this might be undefined. So just to solve it in a hacky way, let's add this exclamation point here. So let's see if this works.
Hello, how are you?
I'm doing good, how are you?
I'm doing good, how are you?
Cool, so it's just repeated what I said. Okay, so let's actually call the OpenAI API. So for that, we'll need to import it. And also to initialize a new OpenAI instance here. And my API key comes from the environment variables. And right here, when the user said something, we can trigger the OpenAI API. So we're just going to use the GPT 3.5 Turbo as our model, and we can pass a list of messages. Just for now, we'll pass a single message that comes from the user. And we can also set temperature 0. And now, instead of replying with the voice input, we can essentially get the response from this completion. And pass it to Twilio. So let's test it.
Hello, how are you?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm an I, so I don't have feelings, but I'm here to help you with anything you need. How can I assist you today?
Okay, so this is the response from ChatGPT. So now after we've actually replied, we can redirect the user back to the incoming message API. So voice response.redirect. This will be a post HTTP request, and the URL is slash incoming URL, same as here. And the problem is that we don't maintain any state. So every time we call the LLM here, the conversation history, it doesn't have any access to the conversation history. So in order to be able to store the conversation history between this request, between the respond and the incoming call API, we are going to use an HTTP cookie. So for that, we'll need some helpers from HONO. So there is a special library called HONO slash cookie, And it has two methods, getCookie and setCookie, which we are going to use in order to maintain a state. So let's start from the incoming call. So we can have a cookie called messages. And if this cookie doesn't exist, it means that this is a new conversation. So right here, we can say the initial message. Actually, let's store that in a variable. So we can say the initial message, and then we can, you know, store the initial state. So let's use the setCookie API. Looks very similar, and we can store a JSON here. And this will be a list of messages, and we'll just use the OpenAI format. So the first message will be a system prompt. So this is a system prompt. We need to start an object here. And the content of this prompt, this can be anything that we want, but let's build, for example, a phone assistant for a pizza restaurant. So you are a helpful phone assistant for a pizza restaurant. The restaurant is open between 10 to 12 p.m. You can help the customer reserve a table for the restaurant. Cool. And then obviously the first real message is going to be a message from the assistant, which is the initial message that we just said in the phone. So now in the response, in the respond API, we actually need to use this state. So let's start by retrieving the state right here. So we can retrieve the state by using the getCookie API. And we'll need to parse that because this is a JSON. And next we'll need to, you know, push our current message here. So this will look like this. So this is a user message and the content is the voice input. So again, this is being called when the user actually says something in the phone. So we'll have the state here and we'll push the message. And here we have an error. Oh, so this actually needs to be parsed. And this needs to be a string, again, solving it in a hacky way. So by now we have a list of messages that we can just pass OpenAI. And after essentially we get a response, we can push the assistant message. So content is the assistant response. And we all can also log the messages here just for so that it will be easier to debug. And finally, we need to actually set the cookie. So we can just copy it from here. Cool. So let's see if this works. So I'm going to open the terminal here. Oh, by the way, this needs to be incoming call, not incoming URL. Yep. So let's open the terminal here and start the call.
Hello, how are you?
Hi, I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. Dan, how can I assist you today?
When are you guys open?
We are open from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Is there anything specific you would like to know or do during our operating hours?
Can I reserve a table?
Of course. I can help you with that. How many people will be in your party?
Two people.
Great. And when would you like to...
Awesome. So this actually works. And you know, from here, we can do classic LLM stuff. We can add tools. We can connect this to our calendar or to our reservation system and so on. Hope you enjoy the video.